Good morning, my dear students. Welcome to St. Michael's e-learning classes. My name is Francis sir, and today we will be studying chapter number 5 from our GK subject of Standard 4. The name of the chapter is the 3 R's. So let's study what this 3 R's is all about. The 3 R's of the environment: reduce, reuse, recycle, help you to go eco-friendly. Now let's see what this 3 R's means. Number 1, reduce. Number 2, reuse. And number 3, recycle. Reduce means to use resources in a limited manner to reduce waste. That means reduce means to use something in a limited manner. Limited is whenever it's required so that we can reduce the waste. Second, reuse means to use things again in a new way instead of throwing them away. So reuse means we have to use the products, that particular product which you are using, again in a new way instead of throwing it as a waste. And the third R is recycle. Recycle is a process to create new products out of the old used material. So recycle means it is a way of creating new products out of the old used materials or things. Now let's connect it, these 3 R's, with the particular exercise which we are about to do. Let's read the exercise. Do you practice these 3 R's? Give yourself a 1 for each habit that you have and 0 for the ones you don't. Check your score on the basis of the score list given at the bottom. So, as you can see, we have certain, you can say, practices which we sometimes do and sometimes we don't. Now, what we are supposed to do in this particular exercise is, if we are doing certain things as per number 1, 2, 3, then we are going to give a 1 in the box, which you can see there. And if you are not practicing that particular thing, then we are going to give a 0. And at the end of the exercise, we are going to calculate how much we have scored. Okay, so let's see these things one by one. Number 1, I buy a toy even when I don't need it because it is new in the market. So, do we have this habit? I buy a toy even when I don't need it because it is new in the market. No, we must not buy a toy even when it is new in the market. Why? Because we are using it. So we must not have the habit of buying a toy even when we don't need it because it is new in the market. When we have got the need of buying a toy, we must buy it, otherwise it will not. So let's give it a 0 in number 1. Second, I buy items that are wrapped in lots of plastic cover. I buy many things that are covered in lots of plastic cover. No, we must not buy those things which are covered in lots of plastic covers. Why? Because it is not good for the environment. So we must give a 0 and we must not practice this habit. Okay? Let's see number 3. I prefer to go by car than by bicycle to school. I prefer to go by car than by bicycle. That means we must go by car or by bicycle while going to school. We must not use a car, we must use a bicycle. Why? Because if we use a car, then the gas which comes out from the car, it is not environment friendly. It destroys the environment. It is also harmful for us. So we must not use a car, rather we must use a bicycle while going to school. So we must give in question number 3, we must give a 0. Let's take question number 4. I write on only one side of the paper. No, we must not write on only one side of the paper, rather on both sides of the paper. Why? We must use it instead of wasting it. Then, so we must give a 0 in question number 4. Question number 5. I always forget to carry a shopping bag to the market. No, we must not forget to carry a shopping bag to the market. Why? Because if we go to the market and if we purchase things, then the shopkeeper will give us a plastic which is not good for the environment. So we must carry our own shopping bag made of wood so that we can save the plastic. So we must give a 0 in question number 5. Question number 6. I pack my food in aluminium wrap. No, we must not pack our food in aluminium wrap, rather in tin boxes. Why? Because this aluminium wrap is not good for the environment and we must only use it when it is required. So we must give 0 under question number 6. Let's see question number 7. I do not like to give away my toys to those children who needs it instead of throwing it. So we give a zero in question number 7. Now question number 8. I use disposable plastic utensils as plates in kitchen. Now what do you mean by disposable? Disposable means which you can use only once, or which we can say use and throw. So we must use disposable plastic utensils and plates in kitchen. No, we must use that type of utensils which we can reuse again and again. Okay? So we must not use disposable plastic, rather reusable. So under this question number 8, we give a zero. Let's see question number 9. I dump the biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste in the same dustbin. Now let's understand what this biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste means. Biodegradable waste means those types of waste which can break down and which can go inside the nature, or we can say mix with the nature. In other words, biodegradable means which are economical or environment friendly, or we can say in short, eco-friendly. Like for example, we have foods, we have plants, we have animals, we have papers, they are all biodegradable waste. Now, non-biodegradable waste on the other hand are those types of waste which cannot break down and go inside the nature. So they are very much harmful for us, they are not eco-friendly. Like for example, we have metals, we have plastics, we have chemicals, they are not eco-friendly. So we must separate these two types of waste, biodegradable waste which are eco-friendly and non-biodegradable waste which are not economic friendly. We must dump these two waste in different dustbins, not same dustbin. Okay? So under question number 9, we will give a 0. Okay? Let's see question number 10. I do not like exchanging story books with a friend. Instead, I like buying new ones. No, we must not have this habit. That is, we must exchange story books with our friends instead of buying new ones. Why? Because in this way we can reuse it and we can save our environment. Okay, so we must give 0 in question number 10. Now, at the end of this particular exercise, you can see we have a score list. Let's see what the score list is telling us. Add all the points and see how eco-friendly you are. So once when you have solved all these 10 questions, you are going to check the score and see how much you have scored. If you have scored in between 5 to 7, it means you are not so eco-friendly. It means that you are not a friend of nature. You do not love nature. If you have scored less than 3, you are eco-friendly, that is, love the nature. And if you have scored 0, that is, if you have given a 0 in all the 10 question answers which we have solved, then you are very eco-friendly. So my dear students, in this particular chapter, what we are studying, what is the aim of this particular chapter? This chapter is telling us that we must love nature, we must protect nature, and we must help our nature so that we can save ourselves, we can save the plants and animals, and we can save this earth where we live. Okay, my students? So in this way, we have finished chapter number 5 of standard 4 of GK. For homework, my students, I would like you to revise this particular chapter, see what this chapter is telling us, especially the 3 hours, and understand it and use it in our daily lives. Thank you.